Hi, everyone. Migos TV. Welcome to another episode of The Bible Seems to Be a Lot More Complicated, especially the Hebrew scriptures, than we want them to be. I think that's a terrible way of describing it, but it is also true. I think we're not willing to do the work of understanding the literary tricks and tools that the authors are using to not only write these stories, but ultimately become divinely inspired in the work of these stories, if that makes sense. So today we're looking at the death of Saul, 1st and 2nd Samuel. That's my wife back there. I don't know if you can hear her on the phone. We're going to look at two different set of verses, okay? Let me pull them up really quick. So who killed Saul? We're going to be at the end of 1 Samuel and at the very beginning of 2 Samuel. Okay, so if you have your Bibles, or I mean, you can Google this, read 2 Samuel chapter 1, specifically the first couple verses. Okay, and then also read the 1 Samuel chapter 31. It's right above it in your Bible. Okay, so a couple interesting things to note here, right? Pause the video and read it, please, so that you can see what we're talking about. In 1 Samuel chapter 31, 3 and 5, we are told that Saul kills himself. He falls on his sword. He actually tells his armor bearer to do it, but he won't do it. So then he just does it. Okay. And then a few verses later, we are told by an Abimelech. I could be saying that wrong. I don't know how to say that correctly. Abimelech. I don't know. You can read. But you're not here for my English speaking. English is also my second language, just an FYI. Amalekite. Amalekite. There you go. It's something like that. An Amalekite killed Saul, a sort of almost mercy kill. And he sees Saul. He tells Saul, hey, can I do anything for you? He's obviously very hurt. And Saul says, yes, take my life. And the Amalekite tells David, I took his life. So the question is, who killed Saul? Okay. And at first glance at this, this can seem like a contradiction, right? Well, who did it? The author is lying. Then that means God's a liar. That means the Bible's not true. Who did it? Right? That is kind of the big question here. And there are scripture deniers, I don't know if that's a word, but like people that want to pick apart the Bible and talk about its contradictions, and they use this place specifically as an example of a contradiction. If the Bible is truthful, if God is real, then why is there this contradiction if this is God's word? But like I always kind of say in the channel, you need to become a better reader in general. If you become a better reader of books, you become a better reader of God's word. And one of the things in reading books is you learn literary style, literary technique. And in 1 Samuel chapter 31, we are told by the narrator, right, what is happening with Saul. And then in 2 Samuel, we are told by the Abimelech, I'm going to have so much trouble with that word, that he killed Saul, right? And so then the bigger question becomes, who do we trust, the narrator or the Abimelech? Who here is more truthful? Who here has something to gain? Who here, do you see that at play? And so is it the narrator that we need to decide that is the truthful one, or the Abimelech, who the author is just quoting because he's using his words, right? He's using this character, this person, and these are the words that he tells David. And so if we do not understand literature, if you do not understand story, you do not understand that those are different people talking. It's the narrator, it's the Abimelech. And it seems like the Abimelech is using what he's saying to try to get ahead, to try as a personal gain. He's telling David what he saw. Or what is happening. And of course, if you're trying to get personal gain from the soon to become king, you're going to try to puff yourself up. And so he sees Saul's dead and there's no one else around. Of course, I'm going to go and say, oh, you're going to be king. And this guy, Saul, was like being a bully to you, trying to kill you. I'm going to try to tell you that I killed him and a sort of trying to tell you that I did it for you because I'm on your side. Not only did I do a mercy killing for Saul, but I did this for you. Does that make sense? And so then the question is not, this is a contradiction. The question is, this is a artistic literary style that the authors of 1 and 2 Samuel are one book. There were two I always say this word weird, two scrolls, not the animal, S-C-R-O-L-L. There were two of them because they were too big. And so there's just 1 Kings and 2 Kings, but they're one book, right? And the author of this is using the voice of the narrator and then the voice of the Amalekite as a literary tool. It's not contradictory. It's just understanding how story works, understanding how literature works. And if we do not understand the complexity, and again, I don't think it's complexity. It is the artisticness of the authors of scripture, of the storytellers of scripture. We think these are contradictions when what really they are is beautiful, good, artistic ways that they're using to write these stories. So, who killed Saul? Understanding the voice of the narrator and understanding the character, the Amalekite. I can't say that. Maybe that's the next thing we need to work on. So, read that. Give me your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below. And yeah, found that very interesting. Had to do a paper on that and research it. Super cool, super crazy. The deeper that I get into this, the more beautiful it is. One book that I would like to recommend to you if you have made it this far is Tim O'Brien, The Things They Carried. And he says this, I quoted this in the paper that I had to write. A thing may happen and be a total lie. Another thing may not happen and be truer than the truth. Peace. See you guys next time.